Hello, I'm Sean from BigRep, and I'm here with Michel David, one of BigRep's senior consultants, to talk about how to properly orient your parts before you print in your 3D printer slicer to get the best results for your application. Why is print orientation so important to consider?
We're talking about big quantities of materials, we're talking about print times and costs, and we want to cut those, we want to be sure we get like the results we need or we want, and that's why it's so important.
And you can save a lot of time and cost just by orienting your print.
Oh yeah, you can save a lot of time and cost obviously, but also get the performance you want from your parts. Yeah, I would like to show you a chart that I came up with.
Of course. That
is summarizing the main aspects you have to look at when you orient a part in the machine volume. So the strength or functionality. Very importantly, you want the parts to perform for the task you print them for. As importantly, aesthetics. The part has to look good or the best you can get out of a printer. Stability is very important, while sometimes you get to parts that are very large or very heavy also, up to 15 or 20 kilos sometimes at times.
Wow.
And in this case, you have to make sure that your part maintains stability throughout the whole print time. And a good orientator will find like the right balance between all those aspects, yeah, for printing the part. In this case, we were requested to print a cover that's a robotic lawnmower cover. The requirement here was for a high surface finish, and the functionality or like the general strength of the part was not so important. We printed it this way. If I were to print a very strong part, I would probably print it in this orientation or maybe flat orientation. But then I will have a lot of contact with support material and I wouldn't be able to enjoy those fine details on the inside of the part, which are very important to incorporate it in the prototype. Now the BigRep software incorporates like an auto orientation, which is optimizing the use of supports. Okay. And by doing so, by minimizing the supports, you also minimize contact with the surfaces of your print, right? Which is a good thing, but yet sometimes you want something else from your part. In this case, I'm going to show you a little bit how you orient in the machine volume. The BigRep machine, the Pro and the One, has a 1 cubic meter volume. You can rotate it in all three axes. You can snap, you can lay the part flat, and it's all about what you need. Remember that it's a big machine and you need to be able to access the print, maybe sometime through the print, because you need to change material. Don't put it at the back of the machine because you're gonna have to lean full body into the machine to get the part out. Put it a little bit towards the front. So you can also monitor and watch the part while printing.
So that's a great example for presentation parts that need to be aesthetically pleasing and minimize post-processing. But what if we're printing an industrial part for functional use?
So I'm glad you asked that because I got another part for us right here. In this case, it's a single propeller blade, which is installed on a big hub with multiple blades. Yeah, so if we were to make an aesthetic model, we would probably print it upright.
Okay.
This is where there's a minimal touch of support with the surfaces. Yeah, but yet we wanted a very functional part. We wanted to, it was actually installed underwater and tested. And in this case, we printed it very strong in the horizontal axis, so it won't snap while rotating.
So if this was printed vertically,
yes,
as you demonstrated, it would break from the weight of the water or the
pressure. That's very right. I mean, this is what we were afraid of, and together with the client, we were like developing this and making a functional prototype.
So just by reorienting a part, you can make it significantly stronger.
That's right. But again, you have to remember that it's a compromise between how much supports you should use and how much contact surface you have with supports, because they tend to come out a bit less nice than the surfaces printed without any touch with supports.
Thanks for watching this episode of BigRep Academy. Be sure to click subscribe to get a notification every time we release a new video so that you can be the first to hear about all of the best tips and tricks for 3D printing.